Hello guys, it's me again. I'm drawing my lot in the Google for this channel, Process Designer. So how are you guys doing? I hope you guys are enjoying our resources and material that we're giving you guys. So if there is anything that you need, any suggestion that you want to make about our platform, feel free to just leave that in the comment section or send us email. So we really appreciate any feedback from you, and we are trying to build a platform here, like trying to meet people, engineers, you understand engineering world here, so we can interact and share our knowledge. So can help us by sharing our videos and resources with your colleagues, and it should encourage us to do more videos. So today I have this cryogenic distillation process of natural gas here. So basically, for cryogenic distillation, it's just distillation of food of natural gas at sub-zero temperature, at very low temperature, to separate it from the from its constituents such like CO2, you understand, and the nitrogen. You know, CO2 is very dangerous to the atmosphere. It causes acid rain, so there's a lot of global warming, and there's a lot of regulation on the amount of CO2 that must be in the sales gas of natural gas. So that's why it's very important. It's a big thing in the industry for the green gas cleaning, acid gas cleaning, you understand, the big thing. So you can use that kind of process to remove, you know, sweeten your natural gas. You can use our cryogenics process, which is the one we have here, you understand. So so the topology of this process is, you can see we have two main distillation column. We have T100 and T101. The T100 is on the cryogenic distillation tower from CO2, is where CO2 is being removed. So when the CO2 is being removed, send at the bottom as a bottom product, you understand, from the column with the higher hydrocarbon like methane, ethane. So it's being flashed from this vessel 100 years. That's where the CO2 is being flashed to the fence and sent to anything like products, anything they want, the CO2 gas. So we have the bottom is sent back to the process. You can use this process it downstream here. So you understand that we have methane rich stream on the top of the CO2 cryogenic distillation column, compressed, then sent to another distillation column for nitrogen remover. So this stream here is basically nitrogen remover. You can make it big, right? Oh, I don't want to remove all this kind of thing. So it is nitrogen gas. So then the bottom from that distillation column is very rich in methane, you understand. So it's sent back. And the work of this LNG exchanger is just to optimize our energy integration. Let's just say energy integration. We want to you don't want to be using a lot of energy in the process to cool down the feed. So you tend to utilize some of the heat of cooling, you understand, the cooling duty of the products, the methane and the higher hydrocarbon stream, so to cool some of the feed, like all the feed, let's say all the feed to no matter where. So either what is there is the oil is before or a refrigeration system for each streaming, you understand, so that we can be very sure of the temperature that is coming in into the distillation column, because you can actually put all your open exchanger, you can easily control temperature of heat exchanger, especially LNG heat exchanger, you understand. So you have to use the heat streaming equipment on the outlet of the LNG heat exchanger, and that's why we have refrigeration system here. But I don't want to model the refrigeration system because it's a loop and it's very difficult, and it's also part, it's not part of the main process. You understand? So that's why I replace it with a cooler, just to stabilize the system a little bit. You understand? Later we deal with the refrigeration system later on. You understand? Then you know the duty stream. So that's the process and so like that. They have pumps and compressor and ETIA for flashing of the CO2. So so that's that. So on part of the response that I'm going to check on the processes or step response, ramp response, the sine wave response, and the lag sine wave response. So we're going to be checking the CO2 phase out analysis on the process too, so that we are sure that the process is efficient enough when it's running in the plant. So because you have to take record of our process variable as we are running the plant, checking the response, you understand. So, and we can only do that with the strip chart. So that's why I'm going to set up strip chart. Yeah, so I'm going to set up important variable that I'm going to monitor in the strip charts, which is the CO2 product. It's basically most of the bonding stream first. So later we are now going to consider the CO2 related, the CO2 flow in all the boundary streams, you know, because the process generally to remove CO2, you understand. So we have the natural gas feed, we have the nitrogen feed, so we mean, okay, so we have the methane rich stream. So don't mind my word names for the streams, it's just so complex to do the simulation and to be thinking about the names when you are working on it. I always do it like this, so when I'm done, I'll just change the name back to any name that I want. So you want to make record like your ledger size to be high, so we can be seeing the change more. You can also change the sample into, I think 20 is also cool. So that's that. So, okay. So let me display. Okay, let me change the graph control. I don't like the background of the graph, so I'm going to change it to this color. I like this color better, make you see better. So so I'm going to make my natural gas stream, because that's where my feed stream, my forcing function to be black, and increase the size to be 1. So then the line thickness to be 1. Then we have methane, which is the product, so it's having the same color. Why is it having the same colors? So I'm going to make that one a little bit thick red. So that will be thick. That one also 1. Basically, make all the color 1. I don't want to make it too big, because if it's big, it won't be clear. So the natural nitrogen gas, you can change that one to be lower color. Well, let's use CO2 product to be blue. The CO2 product are so good. So higher the carbon. I want to use gray. So this color is, let's work with this color. There is one that is even look like the original color, which is nitrogen here. Let's make it something like this. So we can run the integrator and see, because the system is already stable when I stop it, so you just make it run a little bit so you can see it's quite stable. So you scale all like this. This is the product methane, you understand. So these are all the other stream. So mm-hmm. so we can stop the integrator. So now I've stopped the integrator. So the next thing is starting the step function. So I'm going to start the step function because I don't want to be altering the simulation when I'm running the integrator. It somehow creates some kind of, I might not be able to write the word finish because it starts acting on it. So just want to do it one after the other. So I'm going to increase the set point. We are changing the set point, not the stream itself, because I don't know if you want to change the streams or instead you have to configure the stream flow rate with the controller, but that's not realistic enough. We only alter the stream with the valve in pre-plan, so that's why I'm trying to use the valve to measure the to do the set point. So I've done it now, so now it's just to check the response. You can't even tap this thing, so that's the response. So you can see this is the step response increase. So that's the response from the plant. Second order system with lead lag system. You take it to control people, they will note the kind of response that it is. So I think it has stabilized again. So to reduce, I want to reduce the set point again back to 350. 300 mm molar flow. So you just have to check to do your step response on dynamic simulation. So that's the back to 300. So it's coming back to 61. The next thing is doing the ramp function. So check the stream, check the controller, the pressure controller. Those are the integrating variable. If the integrating variable are stabilized, that means the system will also be stable. So the next thing is doing ramp function. So I want to do ramp from 300 to 350 applied. Let's show you. So you go, we can use transfer function block here to do the ramp. And there's something I want to use. I want to tap this. Okay. Let's go. Tap is actually not tapped. Let's make it floating so we can make it as big. Let's tap this one back up. I mean the flow sheet itself, I want to make it floating. Okay, it's now floating. So you can see it very clearly like that. So I think the tap flow is not good. So to do the ramping, you can use transfer function and you can use the controller, but I'm going to do the simplest one, which is using the controller. So till you go to advanced, you can set point ramping there, so you can enable it here. So you specify the target set point on it, yeah, in the ramp duration here. So I'm using 5 mm as default. So I'm going to specify the target set point, which is 350. So we are going to see from the ship chart the work. You can see the ramping effect. So this is the ramping effect of the process. So that's ramp finished at 350 from 300 here. So I think it will stabilize. This is the maintain, yeah, it's on the maintain ridge stream. So this is the COT product that we are getting. So product, we have very hydrocarbon. Those are that's actually low flow fire hydrocarbon, so nitrogen feed, so it has stabilized. So you can check the if I try to drag this time bar, you can see the whole process. It's very somehow funny. So you can see the as the process control the response to disturbance. So I'm going to drop it up, take it back to so going back here and take the pictures back to 300. So it's going to ramp it down again back. So later we, as we do more, we are going to do more work on dynamic process and in Aspen HYSYS. So it's going to stabilize some kind of rumble here. And you can see some of the things that you can see, some of these things are not straight. All these step response are not straight. That's as a result of our valve dynamics here on this. Although the valve dynamics is not that real, it's just the default in this process, so it's very fast. But you can still model your valve dynamics depending on how realistic you want to do your system. But this is just a preliminary work, that's why I'm not even you can control the flow yourself. But you understand, model more hard. You understand, more stickier valve, you understand, to respond and valve dynamics to your process. You understand, do that with going to this tab here. You get the alternator, so second round that time constant. That's where you do fill open, fill short process. Okay, that's where you do your valve dynamics. Modeling. So that's that on ramping. Ramp response going back to 300. Okay. So I think the next thing is to do the sine wave response. We want to check the sine wave response on the process. So so to do that you have to use a transfer function, because you can't do sine wave response with just a controller. So for a transfer function you are going to specify the you can specify the output to be the name of the controller for that we are using for the disturbance is feed, is only feed, flow controller. So you change, you pick the set point for me. So and then you control, you connect the parameter. So you can make this one like constant PV input unit. So make it the unit of the output variable to be also in molar flow, because that 0.25 is in molar flow. Although it's changing in fact now. I'm just going to, so then you say your PV is from, I want to use the same unit that I use for my controller, because that's sometimes if you use different unit like that to just lead to complicated problem. So 0 to 1000. Okay, so I'm just going to use 0 to 1000 for both. That's going to scale down and then scale down, and so you can easily use percentage like that. It will be easier to manage. So this on 325, that will be the input to the transfer function. So you expect the sine wave to be 325, so you can be scaling the 325 for you like. So so you pick the other, I'm using second order system, so I'm going to pick second order system. Okay, so sine wave generator. So you mean the amplitude. The amplitude is just the scale of the span that you specify there, which is the OP, the range from the initial and the final, you understand. So that what is we use to calculate the amplitude of the sine wave that you want to generate. So you don't want to be generating some kind of sine wave that will create problem in the process, you understand. Like it's a process, it's not controlling itself. You just have to make sure it's not operating above the limit. There are limits to this process. If I try to change this set point to something lower than 300 or 200, it's going to create problem downstream, unless I design some kind of fail system, alarm system, you understand, failure relief system on the process, so that to make the process easy. to run. This was like a normal analog process, you understand, like using temperature controller, you understand. So it's just a preliminary work. So we have you select second order. So the amplitude is the span, the percentage of the span. So do you do this? I want it to be 25, so it's going to be 25 divided by 1000. You know, the range is 1000, so we change it to percentage. 25 divided by 1000 is to a percentage. So when I did, I get 2.5, okay, 2.5%. Okay, so that's the percentage. So the time, let's change it to 5. They want it to be high. Later, we'll be changing the time later. So that's the time frame. So, but this controller, I want my process to be neat and smooth. So then I'm going to disable the ramping, set this one to 325. You understand? So you are going to start from 325 and check the response. So it's now in 325. It should well control it in 325. So the controllers control the system to 325, so make it back. So just a small shift, although this still some disturbance. So say it is stabilized later, so let's wait for it to stabilize. So before we run out of error, I go back there. See some noise. So we just start the sine wave and check the sine wave response. So the next thing is I want to, so I'll now put I'll check the output here. It has already given us output, so it's around 300 or something. So I want to be around, I'm going to reset this so that at the same temperature and this at the same output. So I'm going to give this one, okay, let's just put it like that. It will still work, on it. I just don't want to disturb the process too much. That's why I am skeptical like that. So we have this, and that guy, that if you allow me, if I have a control, I would never allow him time my control. So it's starting, you can see somehow. So that's the response or somehow. So as a sine wave response, so you can see it's now working on the sine wave with amplitude. And if you try to measure the amplitude, it's around 350 to 50. You can see when I stop it, I'm going to show you, or you can even check the PPA. You can see 345 or 350, something like that. You can see 349 as I answer 349. Can see that's 350 something. So that's the sine wave response we can put it. Of the processor. And as the process is changing, the other one is also changing. So I'm going to increase the time constants, like the oscillation time of the sine wave. Right, check I'm going to increase this to 10, so 10 minutes. So it's going to change the it's changing the, so you see how it's changing there to, so can see it does increase the size, the frequency of the oscillation. So, and all the process is responding, everything is responding to the change, everything, all the bonding stream, the CO2 products and integrated system beyond the sun, and tying like your damping system or some kind of thing. That's why you can't disturb this kind of process too much, unless you have like set up something. So with this, I think we should check the CO2 fuel analysis, like some stream analysis that you can do with our samples, which is this. Although we have some here, okay. So I'm going to be checking this one to be working in Dynamics. So I'm going to make everything to work in Dynamics. So we are checking if our process, there is CO2 freezing in the process, like CO2 phase out analysis. It's going to be showing, so I'm going to show run the simulation and do the analysis with time, like control period after 10 integration time. So it's going to be telling you the report of the analysis. So if there's any CO2 fizzle out, then I will notice and make some. So this is another code properties. I really don't need this one now, so I'm going to delete it. And basically for all the important streams that I have here, you want to be just add to new one, then pick the stream that you want. So it's quite easy, that's what Aspen HYSYS allows you. So when I run like this, I can check the first one. You can see the temperature, freezing temperature, this is the freezing temperature, this is the phase that the CO2 is facing from. You can see, you can pay the components that is you want to freeze. Although COT is the one that is more liable to freeze most, you can see. All this one is even as a much lower temperature. You understand? So, you can, if you check the stream temperature, it doesn't reach this. You understand? 7, 8. So, let's pick another one out again. I don't have much time to pick for all. So, I think virtually everyone, all the streams are not having problem. Can check the analysis by yourself later, but it's just something I used to check. So that's that. Okay, the next thing is basically trying to change the strip chart variable so that we can check other variable, because this process is generally CO2. We want to remove CO2. We are more concerned with the CO2 flow, not the total flow of the process. So I'm going to change all this mode, file this variable to like component flow of CO2, because there are some variable that have some variable that have CO2 in it that not only natural gas, you understand. So you check for component of CO2 in all this stream, even methane. You can add all the variable there, so you have to pick some important variables, like the one that you want to do a simulation of. So natural gas, I don't think there is CO2 in natural gas, so I'm just going to delete this one and replace it with CO2 in the feed. CO2 in the feed, so natural gas feed, master component, molecule CO2. Send it there, then You can check this new scriptures. Thing is more like it's only showing for this one because others have been replaced. So let me say the legend. And the legend is still cool. Especially this picture here. I want to change it to another a better picture. A better color, I mean. So maybe this color. Okay, I'm going to change the size of all the curves so you can see it legibly. This is the one. So, and also there's one thing that I should do before we start. The axis of the units of the axis, I have to change it back to first component flow. I want to change it to the unit that we are using for the other one. So to be clearer, then I will show all the axes because it's not going to put the two axes on the same line. It's not going to put like it's different kind of variable in Aspen. This the one is component flow, one is molar flow, total molar flow. Yes. So I think we can run now and check our scripture. Okay, you have to scale again. So it's now automatically scaled. So you can see the one top here is the thin IB mode. It's still in IB mode. I have to change it back to maybe I have to change the O variable to I change the old variable to mm from the flow sheet component molar flow. So I've changed it pounds more or something. How am I saying IB mode? So it's in pounds more or something. So if you change now, I guess okay, you can see it's not changing. So although you can run it from that axis where I like, let me see, the equation is just complex. Okay. Now it's not neat. So we have the natural, the one that is coming from the feed. This is the one that is being, okay. The one here is the one that is being removed. 15, the one that we have here, is the one that is being removed as CO2 products, you can see from this string. CO2 product, this is from the feed. So this is the one from methane. In methane, the remaining one in methane, the only one in the higher the carbon. Yes, although you can remove more, but it should make your process more scrutinized. You understand? You want to free the process as much as possible. So that's all the, so that's the CO2 sine wave product. I think last but not least is to check the I'm going to change this one back to 5 seconds, 5 minutes. I mean, then we are going to go to lag sine wave. So that will be the end of this video. I don't want to make a very long video again, so I'll make this one to 5. So you can see it's other kind of response, but these are just important responses. A lot of response in the back. So can see this one, the flipping is asthma increase. Can see this one reduce. It's kind of let me even pick the CO2 product. Let's just do it like this. I want to remove some curve, just the CO2 product curve. and to remove the other cups. Oh, the CO2, you can see this is now the CO2 cup, so it's kind of flip, then it stabilizes this thing. So you can auto scale the cup. So CO2, so this is CO2 cup, so it kind of flip, then stabilize again. So this is the CO2 that's coming out from the top. So I'll show the remaining data. So it's not showing everything again. To scale up, so that's up. So the next thing is I'm going to do the sine wave response, lag response. So this sine wave lag response, we have to is in 325. So it's around 350 now. So I've changed this one back. Disconnect this. I want to disconnect this. I want to make it to auto. So I'll change this to 325. Okay. It's kind of thing where I don't want to do it when I'm running the simulator. So it's going to stabilize the process back so we can see. So before we now do the sine wave response. So I'm trying to stabilize the process back to steady state. So it's not stabilizing the process back. Okay, it will stabilize it again. So we don't really have much time. I think we are going to now do the sine wave. So there are three kind of lag sine wave that you can do. Second order sine wave, you can use the over dam, join the dam, or critically dam, you understand. So you are going to do on the dam first, which is when the damping factor is less than one. So that is, we are going to put it 0.1 so that you can see the response very clearly. And the amplitude has to be different now, because the amplitude there is just the way multiplier of the steady state, the inputs, you understand, is the way gain k, not like time wave, which is the, which you have to use the range, the fraction of the range. So I'm going to use fraction because I want the output to be in 350. The gain, the steady state gain of this set point say to be 350. So you have to find the fraction that you multiplied with this new, the steady state that I'm inputting, the PV variable, the input variable that I'm giving, you understand, which is 350. So that will give you 350. So you have to divide 325, 350 divided by 325, you understand, that will give you the fraction by you. So the fraction is now 1 point something. So the fraction is 1.077. So you can do the fraction. So you can, if you want to scale the PV, that is, you don't want to be because the most time it's scale the PV that you sent, that before it applied the transfer function on the PV with the range of the PV that you have here, you understand. So instead of assuming I put the range to be around 300 and 350, this PV that is going to return is not going to be 325, it's going to be 50, depending on the range, you understand. It's going to scale this based on, because they are having the same range, so it's easy, you understand. Even if it's sending 325, it's still going to see the output as 325, you understand. But if the range is the fast, it's going to find the scaling, that is the ratio of the input, you understand, that is the 325 divided by 325 divided by 1000 minus, you understand, times 1000 minus 0, you understand, it still give you 325. So assuming if you change this one to 500, you understand, that will be half, you understand, half, like, you understand. So that's the half of the that we send to the transfer function. So you have to be very sure of what you are picking. So I don't need this, that's why I don't pick it. So I put the scaling factor to be 5 and 5 seconds. So the next thing is to change it back to cascade. So to make it from, so you see the set point from remote like that. So you can check the response now. Okay, that's the response. So that's the okay from this, as when I change it back to 325, you understand. To allow it to stabilize. Okay, what is happening is just the valve is not big enough to occupy the process. It was the valve, so that's what happened here. This one is natural gas with yeah, so easy valve. This one is CO2 product. It's pretty more like steady state. Second order response. You can see these are the overshoots. There should be another overshoot here, but it's just the valve is somehow is not being stabilized yet. So I'm going to run it again. You understand, change it to everything because I'm changing the set points, and that is disturbing. That's an external disturbance to the process because I'm changing the set points. So I'm going to change it back to from when it's stabilized to 350. I'm going to change it back to 325, and then we now do the remaining two. So. And that one is faster, the critically damp and over damp disturbance. Okay. This one is supposed to be somewhere, this one is CO2 product stream. So you have this one too. It will stabilize now. Once you allow the process to stabilize before you start running. That's overshoot 53, 51. It's now stabilizing now. So I'm going to change it back to 20 bucks to lower set points now. So I want to change that to lower set points. So you pick it to 1 back. So it is stabilized out to 325. Change back to stay back to 325. I've disturbed the process here. You can see our quality just for going back to where it's going to. Some step response is somehow difficult. It's because of the gauges are so stabilized like that too. To come down and go up. Okay, this one is going down. That's the overshoot. You can see the overshoot bottom here. This is the overshoot too. Oh, you skill. So when this one stabilizes, so we are going to do the critically down and the over down. Yes, sponsor. It is stabilizing. So it's now stabilizing back again. Can see the overshoots and the retention time. So next I'm going to do the, I've not tried, you know, waste a lot of time. So I'm going to do the critically down first. So for critically down, we put this one to 1. You understand? Then change it back to 3. You understand? The scale back, so you take it to 350. Let's see what's going on. Oh, it's coming up. That's a disturbance on the process. You understand? If you want to do you want to control the process, maybe you have a fixed operation condition, then you have to redesign the topology of the process. You understand, by putting different kind of controller, you understand, valve flow specification. This is just to stabilize the process, because if you want to do design, you have to stabilize the process first, then later you can just you can put hold up, do you understand? So it should take care of any disturbance in the upstream. This is integrated system, and when you have integrated system, you're not supposed to disturb the feed. You understand? So there are different kind of control mechanism that you can still use to get to your production target time. So this one is, you can see over there on critically damped system. So this is response of critically damped system. Yes, you can see over damped system, that's a response sound wave. So critically damped started from here. The next thing we are going to do, overdam system now. Overdam, that is when the damping factor is greater than 1. So I'm going to put damping factor in 2. So So change this one to 1 so that it make it in 325. Yes. So I think that's what we are going to basically do today. So then this one stabilized. I already checked the whole plots, printed. Can show you your results, but that's the people. Oh, there's no overshoot for critically down system. So you expect this. So when this reaches 325, that's still or very close to 325. So you expect. It will stabilize. So this is one of the most of the plot that I'm working on. Can see from step, sine wave, then up, down. Do you understand? So then critically down, over down on the dam system. Understand? Okay. So that's everything. I will stop the integrator now and save the PX. Let's check. Okay, it reached 25. So, stabilize. So that's the video. So thank you for your time. Thank you. I hope you are able to learn some how to do analysis and tests, you know, to check for response of your dynamic modeling in Aspen HYSYS. So check for step response, sine wave response, and the overdamp, underdamp system response, and critically damp system response, and overdamp system response. You understand? So thank you very much. Thank you for watching.